Pleasure to meet you. My name is Austin. I'm the marketing manager for Vielight. How are you doing?
Awesome.
Firstly, thank you so much for agreeing to do like a testimonial video type of thing, and I guess maybe recapping a bit about yourself, a bit about your experience, and then kind of how you discovered Vielight.
Okay, got it. All right. My name's Belinda Zipf, and I'm 69 and a half years old, relatively healthy, have lived in Ohio and South Carolina in my life. My first symptom was about in July 22, and I asked my primary care doctor for a referral to a neurologist. So I eventually started going through everything, the PET scan, the MRI, the Quest blood test. I had the APOE4 gene, I found out. And so that was in July 22. I finally was diagnosed and got through all that in September 21st, 2023. And yes, everything showed amyloid everywhere in my blood, in my brain. And surprisingly, I was fairly high functioning because I've always been fairly high functioning, but I self-diagnosed. So my husband, being a biochemical undergrad, biochemical undergrad, he started trying to find something like the flicker. And that's how he went from taking it from there to taking his knowledge about the cell and the mitochondria and all those reactions, CO2, and you name it, all they are. And he found a competitor of yours originally. And then we got to looking further and we said, I probably should knock that part out. But anyways, he was very impressed with the Vielight. And so we got the very first NeuroPro, not the Duo. Got the first NeuroPro. And we started it. I started it. And that's kind of where I am now. And honestly, I'm just better than I ever was. Honestly, better than I ever was. It's just better. I can't even tell you how my brain pulls out things from, I don't know, high school. I was looking at a reunion book. It wasn't even my class. And I started naming all these people. I'm like, Bill, I can't. I mean, it was surreal. It was surreal.
When you first started using the Vielight, so it was because your husband, I guess, had mentioned this is something. Is it something that you were skeptical about at first, or did you in your head think, oh, this is something that might be able to work? Were you a skeptic at first?
We're both in medicine, and I'm a PhD, he's an MD, and
Okay.
no, we and we did, that's the other most important thing. We did clinical trials in our career on children. Yeah, placebo-controlled, trials, observation trials, state phase four trials, you name it. So we did that at the institution where we were at. So we knew clinical trials. And so no, I mean, we ordered it right away. We didn't even think about it. It wasn't even a, okay, let's sleep on it. No, we went for it immediately. So we didn't have that, but that's likely because of our background.
Did you notice it in yourself, or is it that he noticed it in you? Like, yeah, maybe if you can share some stories about that.
Yeah, I had a journal and I kept track of my journal. And so I started literally starting the therapy like around 131, 24. And it was subtle. It wasn't, oh wow, now I'm different. But by March 10th, I wrote in my journal, just like before, I'm completely fine. I mean, literally, that was a quote, just like before, I'm completely fine. So, and then around 3-1, I noticed I was still kind of May 1, I mean, March 1, I'm still kind of, I don't know yet, but I think so. But it was definitive on March 10th. So that was quick. That was quick.
Okay, wow. And so you said you use it like on an ongoing basis now. Have you ever been off it for a period of time, and do you notice any differences in yourself when you're off it?
Gosh, I started feeling it in July 22. And like I said, I'm not, I just knew I was out of sync. I mean, at that point, I didn't have symptoms, but I felt like I had to work cognitively a little bit more to grasp things. And I realized also early on, I couldn't follow a novel. I couldn't read a book and stay into it and remember what I read the day before. So that was pretty early. When it became a problem was when I got lost driving to comfortable places, places I've been to a lot. I was lost in train of thought. Seriously. This question is a no-brainer.
Yeah.
He kicked me out of his practice. He kicked me out of his practice because he says, I told myself a long time ago when I did medicine, I only do clinically tested or under development therapeutic work in my field. And I got a letter that he discharged me. So my husband and I went back with all the data, all the molecular data. I mean, because we said, we're researchers, you know, what you're talking about me to wait for is 13 years and I'll be gone. You know,
right.
Leqembi's no, you know, no miracle drug. And so that was distressing for me. And it's very distressing to me. So then I had to find a new one. I had to beg to get in this other practice in Georgia, actually.
Okay.
And the doctor walks in. So second doctor walks in and said, I don't really know why you're here. I mean, you have everything. And he talked to me a little bit about it. He says, you have this and this. We talked. And I said, well, I had to leave my other practice. I really didn't say why. And he looked at me and said, all I know is, yes, you have the signs of Alzheimer's in your brain. You have zero dementia. So whatever you're doing it right.